Based on the research, what we have done, if you really want to put a great service culture in place, there are a few attributes here which we have identified, about 18 attributes which are common. All in all, I have found there are about 30 attributes that got to be there in putting a great service culture right. Japan, they do practice all those 30 attributes, virtually all. But in this part of the world, we are developing countries, we have found that to put a great service culture in place, we have to put about those 18 attributes right. Or, yes, there are how many? 18 or more, or 20 attributes, whatever. Now, to what extent do we practice them in our organization? Just think about it. Look at those attributes. Do assessment to yourself. And see to what extent do we practice them in our organization. Practice these mantras and then see things that you can execute. All these elements what we have found here, you can execute. Now, I would add about another 10 to this in Japan, and that's about the only country where I found almost 100% they practice this. Treating a human being as a human being is in their DNA, Jit, our experience. Treating a human being as a human being is in their DNA. 95% of the Japanese cannot speak English. And they are so efficient. Average walking speed of a Japanese is 8 kilometers an hour. Although they can't speak English, although they are so busy, you as a foreigner, you ask, here where a busy Japanese who is walking in, excuse me, guy will stop. You ask, how to get to Shibuya? He didn't understand anything. But he will read your body language. How to get to Shibuya? We are clarifying about a place, but that also I'm sure we didn't pronounce the place right. He would make an attempt to understand. He said, Shibuya, Shibuya. He will stop his journey. He will come along with us now to the nearest railway station. Then he will walk according to his speed, our speed. It's a difficult thing. He will go a bit forward and wait until we come right. Okay. He will help us to get the ticket. He will come along with us to the platform. Wait until the train comes. And he will put us onto the train, bow and then go. Treating a human being as a human being is in their DNA. And they provide this fine. Look at these attributes. I'm not here to cover up everything. It's about a 2 days work to going to cover up these things. But I picked up certain simple things from these attributes. Number one is, my dear friends, the word positive. Nowhere on the earth a great service culture can be said by being negative. Will you agree with me? If you say impossible, why should we? We shouldn't. No way. And often that's what I said. Sometimes when you are ignorant on a subject matter, you become arrogant. We had experienced this enough in organizations. And as a result, you become negative. Now, this is something needed, positivity. When you are recruiting staff, check for their positive attitude. More than the qualification, that's what we got to look into. And last time when I ran the program, the managing director of this company, he gave me the brief and he said, we spend ₹1 million in advertising. But I consider more than that, there's something what we can do if we can achieve this. He said, the greatest promotion one can do is step into the enterprise with a positive frame of mind. We as set of workers, if we go to organization with a negative frame of mind, dear friends, we'll never be able to set up a great service culture. So the word positivity in that model, something that you've got to put it into practice.